When extruding filament, it is crucial to maintain a consistent diameter to achieve great 3D printing results. However, that isn't always easy, as it can be quite hard to measure the hot moving wire with, let's say, a caliper. To provide an easy solution to this problem, we offer the Jarvis Laser GE, a filament measurement device that uses lasers to give you an accurate real-time readout for your production line, so you know if your filament is out of spec right away. With the help of our desktop software, the measurements can then be visualized as graphs and exported to, let's say, a spreadsheet. Hello, I'm Simon and I'm CEO and software developer here at QiTech Industries. When you receive the package, it will obviously contain the DRE itself. It is capable of measuring diameters ranging from 0.2 to 30 millimeters with an accuracy of 2 microns at a sampling rate of 50 Hz. You will also find a power cable, a Modbus to USB cable, 2 calibration rods in 4 and 8 mm in diameter, as well as filament guiding rollers with mounting screws. On request, we also include a metal stand, which can be adjusted between 66 cm and 121 cm. Let's get started by setting up the DRE for operation. Firstly, you need to mount the filament guiding rollers to the DRE. If you purchase the stand, adjust it to the correct height and screw the DRE onto the metal plate. Next, plug in the power cable in either a 230 volt or 110 volt outlet and switch it on by pressing the button below the buzzer. Before first usage, an initial calibration is required to make sure that the measurement is accurate after transport. To do this, navigate to the calibration menu, then choose the two rod sizes, 4 mm and 8 mm are already preset. Then place the rods onto the rollers, one after another, and confirm the calibration after each. Now you're all set, and the filament diameter will be displayed on screen. What might come in handy for production as well is the out-of-tolerance alarm. It can be activated or deactivated by pressing the right arrow key when on home screen. As soon as the filament runs out of spec, it will let you know with a loud acoustic signal as well as a red blinking light. There are three settings to change the sensitivity of the alarm: the target diameter, the upper tolerance and the lower tolerance. While the standalone operation might already be sufficient for some use cases, the magic happens once you make use of our very own desktop software and connect the DRE to your PC with the provided cable. The software can be downloaded from our website and is available for Windows, macOS and Linux. You can find a link to it in the description. To ensure that the DRE can be recognized by your PC, you need to check whether the connection settings are all to default. Navigate to the connection submenu, select 8N1 for the parity setting, board 38400 and protocol Modbus. A card called Jarvis DRE should now appear in the machine overview. By pressing the pen icon next to the name, it can also be renamed to your liking, especially useful if you own two or more DREs. To access the DRE control panel, simply click the card itself or use the navigation bar on the left. Now we are on the production tab, where you can see everything you need to know about your filament diameter at one glance. On the top here, the filament diameter is displayed as a line graph with an intolerance values highlighted green and out of tolerances ones red. The graph auto-scales in height but can be adjusted in pan and zoom with the help of the navigation handles below. The horizontal dotted line visualizes the target diameter. As you can see on the top right hand corner, you can also export all the measured values in Excel, CSV and PNG format with the click of a button. New values are retrieved every second, but measurements are taken faster at a rate of 5 per second. Going further down, there are the tolerance and alarm settings. Just as with the settings on the DRE itself, you can choose the target diameter, acceptable tolerance in both direction, and an action that is triggered when the diameter runs out of spec. For convenience, the bottom right-hand corner also contains the current diameter on a cross-section view. We also integrated a convenient data marker tool, which can be used to track the diameter to one specific spool. It's best to add a new marker once you start winding an empty spool. Then just keep the filament running and add a stop marker once the spool is completely filled up. That way you can get the diameter and tolerances across a single spool only. When using Excel export, the markers will also be contained within the file. One thing to keep in mind is that settings you make here won't be synced back to the DRE and that you need to stay on the DRE home screen in order for the desktop software to receive values from the machine. Oppositely though, you can sync the tolerance values from the DRE to the Jarvis control app by pressing the sync button. In case you are unsure what any of the input fields do, you can jump directly to the correct section of the integrated handbook by pressing the question mark icon next to the title. Speaking of the handbook, you can access it by choosing the Handbook tab next to the Production tab. It contains every detail you need to know about operating the DRE, fixing possible errors, and integrating the DRE into your system. Another convenient feature is the option for wireless control with the tablet or phone. While the DRE and Jarvis Control app operate completely offline, it is still possible to access the interface from within your local network. We showcased this with an iPad, but it will work with any Wi-Fi capable device, even your BlackBerry.
Wir haben doch gar kein BlackBerry.
Yeah. Just open the browser on your device and type in the URL that is presented on the machine overview page. Now we have the exact same control panel on our iPad and we can view the diameter or adjust any settings in the app. For the pro users among you, there's also the possibility to integrate the DRE into your existing bus system or write custom scripts. When connecting via Modbus RTU, input register 0 will hold the current diameter while registers 102, 103 and 104 contain target diameter, upper tolerance and lower tolerance respectively. You can find a more detailed explanation including code samples for Python and Node.js inside the handbook. If you want to learn more about the Jarvis DRE or want to get in touch, feel free to visit our website or contact us via email or phone.